For the best liberty-oriented talk 24/7, visit LRN.fm.
You know, it's funny when you look at the Wikipedia page for the non-aggression principle, it doesn't actually include a copy of the non-aggression principle. In fact, it seems like there's never really been any one sentence that folks have agreed on as the dominant version of the non-aggression principle. Wikipedia just says, quote, the non-aggression principle, .. is an ethical stance which asserts that aggression is inherently illegitimate, unquote. And then it goes on as trying to define aggression, and it gets more and more complicated, and pretty soon you're back where you started. I tried to improve on this by making a statement that was pretty airtight, or at least I thought it was, and the statement goes, or went, like this. Don't initiate harmful force, fraud, or endangerment against others without their consent. This was probably an improvement over some of the other statements, versions of the sentence, that seem to have holes in them, big ones. You know, for instance, when people say, well, you're free to do whatever you want as long as you don't harm others. That has a big hole in it, in the sense that you should actually be able to harm others as long as they're the ones that initiated the harm against you, and it was sufficiently big harm to justify reaction. As long as they initiated it. The initiation business is very important. It's an important word for the sentence. But I'm going to actually go ahead and take it out of an improved version of the sentence. Let's put it like this. Quote, basically, you should avoid committing acts of aggression. Unquote. I think this version of the sentence leaves enough wiggle room so that you can handle the case where a kid is walking out into traffic and you force him back onto the sidewalk. Or you need to commit an act of defensive violence that protects you against an act of aggression. I think fraud can be covered by this without being over-covered. So for instance, if you say you shouldn't initiate force or commit fraud, well then you're almost laying too big of an umbrella, sort of like you're saying a person can't commit an April Fool's joke or do, I think, what was done in the Killing Fields movie. I didn't actually see it. I just remember hearing about it from a Christian relative who believes, supposedly, that all lying is forbidden. But she was praising the acts of, I think, a journalist who convinced some of the Rouge that the persons he or she was with were French instead of American, thus avoiding them being killed. But they were American, it was a lie. So this was an act of fraud. You don't want your zero aggression principle forbidding that kind of act of fraud, for sure. And this one doesn't. When you say, again, a quote, basically, avoid acts of aggression, unquote. Going back to fraud, the fraud question, I think this sentence covers acts where you go in, you know, and you trick someone into giving you some of their money and then you run off with it. That can be considered an act of aggression. Violating a contract in a way that causes someone monetary expense can be considered an act of aggression, so that seems to be pretty covered, you know, if you initiate the violation, but probably isn't covered if you don't initiate the violation. Aggressive investing is not prohibited by the statement. We all want people to be able to do aggressive investing or aggressive basketball playing. Neither of those are going to generally be considered acts of aggression. One hole, though, that still remains is animals. I don't know how to address them, and maybe you can come up with a better statement. You should put it in the comments section. So it is an act of aggression for me to go to the store and buy a slice of ham. It's going to be considered an act of aggression under that statement that I previously spewed out. Basically, avoid acts of aggression. Basically covered. And I'm not positive it should be. But it wouldn't be a worse world if it were covered. I mean, if everyone stopped eating ham, I don't think the world would be worse. I think it would be a better place, even though I can't stop myself from eating just a little bit. I am only a reducitarian, so I arguably am not fully in compliance with this sentence that I've created. Ultimately, it's asking a little bit more than we can expect humans to really deliver at this point. It's almost like going off mission to bring animals into this thing, which is already so difficult to... it's already so difficult to even get humans to stop aggressing against each other. You know, so should it say something differently? Should it say, basically, avoid acts of aggression against humans? Well, that leaves this whole problem of, well, what happens when the aliens show up? You know, we're supposed to be treating them just as well as we treat us. Or when we're on another alien world. Or if we discover that dolphins really do have the intelligence of a 15-year-old when we thought it was a 9-year-old, and they're really basically full-blown sentient. And now the word humans doesn't cover enough. I don't know. Think about this while you're in the shower. And get back to me in the comments section. Come up with something better. Oh, I've even thought of an improvement already myself, I think. How about changing it to, quote, basically don't commit acts of aggression, unquote. In any case, we need something that the average people we're talking to, you know, elevator pitching, can understand more or less immediately. And fill in the holes later. And something that sounds like, I don't know, winsome or... popular, I don't know.
LRN.FM, 24 hours of Liberty Radio every day. Now available on satellite, too, at sat.lrn.fm. That's what a satellite sounds like. Put it on your unlicensed station. Wear it in your hair. But above all, don't despair. The Liberty message is getting out. And right now, you're missing it. Or maybe you're not. But skip on over to
LRN.FM. Bet you don't want you to hear them.